Good morning students and welcome to the online class of OpenOffice Calc. So today in this session we'll be discussing about the menu bars used in OpenOffice Calc and how to do a simple calculations. So you can see that I am on the screen of that OpenOffice Calc. I have opened the spreadsheet from OpenOffice.org. Now the extension of OpenOffice Calc, I have already told you, that is .ods. The first bar which you are seeing here, that is called as the title bar, where the name of the file is displayed. It is right now it is showing untitled one, but when you will store it, when you will save it with your own name or any other name, it will be shown displayed here. Now the second bar is called as the menu bar, which shows the different menus which you can use while working on OpenOffice Calc. The third one is the standard toolbar, which contains the shortcut menu of the most frequent commands which are used. So that is the shortcut menu. First one you can see, that is the new. So new workbook can be opened from here. Here you can open the existing one. Now you have to note down the shortcut keys also for all these, so that it is easy to work with all these commands. It is for saving the file, saving the workbook. It is for documenting the mail. So these are the shortcut, cut, copy, paste. These are the shortcut for all different commands which are frequently used. The fourth one is the formatting toolbar, which helps you to format the cell, change the, you can change from here the font style, writing style of the text. You can increase the size from here or decrease accordingly. You can do bold, italic and underline. From here you can set the alignments, which is left, right, center and justified. Now these are the some other commands which can be used to fill the color, change the font color. You can fill the color of the cell. So now if I click here and click on this, so it can be filled here. You can, if you are writing something, suppose I am writing here Rahul, so it can change the font color of Rahul, so it can be easily changed. Right now it is not visible, so you can see. Let me increase the size so that it is visible here. So you can see that I have changed the, you can easily change the color here. You can increase the size. You can also change the writing style from here. You can change the writing style from here of the text. So this is how this, these are the bars. And now the numbers which you are seeing on the top, these are called as the column name and column letters, and these are the row numbers. The row begins with 1 and the column begins with A. This bar which you are seeing here above this name of the column and rows, you can see this bar, this represents the, it is called as the address bar, or you can say it is also called as a name box, which contains the name of the current active cell. Suppose my cursor is here on A2, so you can see it is A2. If you go here, it will be changed to D7. If you want to see the address of the particular cell, you can just click on here and check the name box or the address bar. On the right side, there is a formula bar where we write the formulas. Each formula in Excel or in OpenOffice Calc begins with equals to sign. Whatever you calculate in Excel or Calc, it begins with the equal to sign, right? And it depends totally upon the address. That is why the address bar is given here. Now suppose if I want to directly go to the AA column or AZ column, there is no need to scroll here and there. You can directly write the cell address, suppose AA1, and then you press enter. You can see here that you are on AA1 cell, which is the active cell now. So directly by writing the name of the cell reference in the name box or the address bar, you can directly go to the cell. Alright, so this is, suppose now you have not scrolled, or maybe you by mistake it has been scrolled to the last cell and you want to go to the A1 cell. So you can simply write A1 and press enter. You will be on the current active cell, which is the first cell of the workbook or the worksheet. Alright, so this is how these are the bars, and on the bottom side you can see the three sheets which are the default sheets mentioned here. Below that there is a status bar which shows the status of the book. In, you can see that there are three sheets and you are on the first sheet. When you change the sheet number, it will be changed. Alright, so this is how the status bar shows the status. Here there is a zooming percentage from where we can increase or decrease the percentage. I have increased it so that it is quite visible to you while doing the calculation. Now let us write something and do a simple calculation here. So suppose I am writing here name, then I am writing class, and suppose I am writing here marks of the student. So right now I am writing, suppose Rahul, Pooja, Neha, Priya, and the class will be suppose 9 only. And the marks suppose are 70, 80, 90, 67. So these are the marks suppose. Now for example, if you want to adjust the cell, you can do it. Go here, drag your mouse pointer here. This is called as a cell pointer, wherever your cell points. Now if you move your cell pointer here, you can see there is a plus kind of symbol. You can just adjust it to the space where you want, and you can just do it like this. Alright, so you can see that I am doing it like this. Now if you want to change the alignment of the text, suppose you want that these should be displayed in center, so you can click on the center. Now suppose if I want to do a total of these marks, so what I will write here equals to, and then sum, and then I'll start the bracket. You have to write the cell reference here. The cell reference of this first cell is C2 and the last cell is C5. So you have to write C2 is to C5. Either you write it like this, C2 is to C5, or if you don't want to write it, you can just simply go to the first cell and drag it till here. It will be done, and then you have to close the bracket and press enter. It will give you the total of the marks. So this is the total of the marks. Suppose if I want to change the alignment here to center, I have done it. If I want to fill the color so that it looks nice, so it is done. If you want to change the color here also, you can change it. If you want to increase the size, let's increase it, and you can do like this. So this is how the total marks can be find out for the particular student. This you can do it at home. Try to create a marks, write the marks of all the subject in different columns, and try to calculate the total for all the subjects. Now suppose if you have written here marks of English, Hindi, Maths, Science, SST, and then do a total here. So how you will do a total if the marks is written like this? So you can, suppose I have written here like this marks. So you will write here equals to, and then sum, start the bracket, drag these marks here, and then close the bracket, press enter. So this is how you will get a marks of one student. If you will drag this to the different cell, it will give you the marks for different student. Right now it is not giving. Why? Because the data is not present here. Suppose if I have entered the data here, now you can see that the marks are changing. Alright, so this is how it is done. Let me write the subject also. Suppose I have written here Maths, English, Hindi, Computer, and this total marks. Alright, so this is how the total marks can be calculated for each subject. So try to practice this at home. Create a sheet wherein you create the marks for your class only, and write the formula, try to solve it, see that the marks are coming in a proper way or not. And if you have any problem, then get back to me. Thank you so much.